You're welcome today to DMSI channel as usual. Yes, don't ask me whether I saw any patients today. I did see my a few patients today, but today I saw them at the airport, you know what I mean? So I'll see patients that were traveling. Okay, so I'll be talking about something that a lot of people may not really know about, or they know about but they don't care about. You see, every time when we make arrangements for travel, if we want to travel out, especially, you prepare for everything. You prepare for your hotel accommodation. You prepare for places that you'll be visiting. For those who, especially when you're traveling, is entirely for vacation or tourism. And then you prepare for everything, but there's this one thing that people really don't prepare for. All right. So at the airport today, I spoke to a few persons. I was asking questions, and I was asking them specifically, how prepared are they for emergencies? A lot of us know what insurance is. I had described insurance as a preparation for some emergencies or an accident, okay? So travel insurance is a combination of a few things. Of course, you know what car insurance is now. You buy a car, or even when the car is every year, you go to the insurance companies and then you insure your car against accidents and theft. So for travel insurance, you actually insure the period of travel against a number of things. All right, you insure against baggage losses, you insure against emergency evacuation, and then you insure against, especially, you insure against medical emergencies. And that's what actually we'll be talking about, medical emergencies, because, well, emergencies occur anytime, and there's really never any time that we are actually prepared for such emergency, be it when we are away from our homes or regional locations, or even when we are in our location. But it's actually worse if you are in a location, if you are in a foreign place, and then a medical emergency comes up. You understand what I'm saying? Now, depending on where you are going to, again, I am aware that most countries in Europe, UK, and the neighboring countries, there is to a large extent there is free Medicare. But believe me, guys, if you are going to a place like the United States of America, there is need for you to get a travel insurance, all right? And specifically, the insurance that I'm talking about here, the benefits that is inherent in the travel insurance that I like to enumerate, that I like to really enlist, is the benefit of Medicare. Of course, the United States of America is one country where healthcare is still not free. And healthcare is a huge problem there. Financial healthcare is a huge problem there. It is the reason why every election here, healthcare and whether or not there should be insurance or the kind of healthcare that they should adopt has always been a topic for discussion, has always been something to talk about. And of course, it is not cheap. That's something that we must know. I've been there and I know exactly what I'm saying. And I've seen people go bankrupt but because they were unable to pay their Medicare. For cases, for incidences that they really didn't plan for. I've seen people denied visas to return to the United States because the last time that they were there, they had problems, health problems. They went to hospitals and they were given huge bills that they were unable to pay and they are still unable to pay. So this is one area of your travel arrangement that everybody needs to look into in preparing for traveling. But I like to mention that for me, every time that I had to travel or my people I know are traveling, I make sure that I get Mansard, that's all you call Azar Mansard, to buy some kind of travel insurance. Fortunately for me, I really have never used it. But the amount that you pay as premium for a travel insurance is so thin, all right, relative or compared to what it will cost you if you don't get it. So this video is to encourage you. Like I said, I spoke to a number of persons before I said I should make that video, and I found out that only one out of 10 persons who travel, especially are traveling out of their original location in terms of international travels, actually make arrangements for such medical emergencies in terms of health insurance or in terms of some kind of insurance. All right. So fortunately for me, all the time that I've needed to buy, that I've bought this Azar Mansard travel insurance with the view that I may benefit from their Medicare should anything happen in terms that requires medical attention, I've never really used it. But before I learned that lesson to make sure that I buy travel insurance, I've been in that position before, and so I'm talking out of experience. You'll be surprised how many thousands of dollars that you'll be required to pay. And most of the time, even when they give you time to pay, it is still enormous. The impact is still a lot on you. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to draw the curtain here. Maybe sometime in the future, we'll be talking about all the other kinds of insurance and some of the insurance company, what you need to look out for if you must buy a travel insurance as you prepare for your next travel. I'd like you to continue to subscribe to this DMS I channel. As you are aware, we like not to bore you with things that are irrelevant. And we have told you before that the channel is out there to make some social impact. We hope that this video has brought some knowledge to you. We hope that you've been impacted. We hope that the next time when you need to travel, amongst the things that you actually will be arranging for, among the plans that you'll be making, you will make sure that in your kit that you have a travel insurance, especially the one that has part of it, Medicare. Thank you.